tendenze fuori controllo. We should enter the industry. his working method, in his production method, why he is giving you the different kinds of goods. So that thing is going to be helpful for you as well. So now the next point, point number 8.
By cost, but it is result of decisions taken on the basis of the service.
the interpreter undertakes any enterprise by arranging proper system, taking support of the inventions, and obeying certain theories, he can certainly avoid many risks, and thus entrepreneurship does not remain risky. So here the next point, strategy for taking the less risk. Suppose if I am doing the business, by doing the business there is an uncertainty regarding the profit or loss. Though I am investing my rupees 5 lakhs and I don't know whether that 5 lakhs going to be the 7 lakhs or 2 lakhs or the 0. So that is the risky element in my business. If it is successful, then you have took the risk that is going to be there. But if it is unsuccessful, then it is not going to be beneficial for you as well, for the entrepreneur who is working. So here they are specified why you are doing the business. You should take the calculated risk first. And you should try to avoid the risk. Do the business in which there are the least chances of risk. If it is not so possible, you calculate that part and try to avoid the risk. I have the options. If I take the insurance, so I should take that. I should not be the person without taking the insurance and doing the business and damaging my products. So these are the things which are going to be helpful. So according to Professor Carlo, he says that the person who is not the one who will get maximum profit by taking the more risk. The person should try to avoid the risk as much as possible so that the risk proportion is become in various business become the least part, and future he can earn the profit as well. So this thing he should make strategy. He should try to take the risk as less as possible. So he has to be the person who is doing the business will not suffer from the loss. So the strategy for taking the less risk. So the first point is capacity for risk bearing. Second, tendency for innovation. The third point is process based on knowledge. Fourth, activity based on theory. Fifth is tendency for constructive activity. Next is tendency for creating resources. The seventh is result of changes. Eighth, entrepreneurship is a practice. Ninth, strategy for taking the risks. Now the tenth point. building up his reputation goodwill. How he is going to handle the business? So now the 11th point. Inevitable quality for every entrepreneurship in itself is the characteristics which can be essential for any field of work. That means the entrepreneurship is not a monopoly for economic or industrial field only, but an essential characteristics for the field related to human life. The person is not a natural quality. Generally, it is believed that the quality of entrepreneurship is naturally inherent in an entrepreneur, but it is not true because it is not an inborn quality, of course. But he has to make the conscious effort for the cultivating it and creating the tendency for entrepreneurs. The entrepreneurship is not a natural, but in order to get and develop it, one has to make efforts in a specific direction. So in the point number 12, entrepreneurship is not the natural quality. Though if the ancestor of your family are doing the business from a long time, but that is not going to be the natural in you. You have to build up that things. You should know the things properly. How to do the business, how you are handling the situation, you are having the risk taking ability, you are a person of a leader or not, how is your personality, how you are going to manage the things as well. So this thing the individual should cultivate, should learn. If the person is not learning and diving into the things, then he is not a good entrepreneur. He is not going to be successful. For that person, he should learn the things, he should cultivate. you have to read the name on this one. So the first category is safe for discovery, second is content, safe for innovation, third process based on knowledge, fourth activity based on theory, next second is for constructive activity, next content is for creating resources, next result of changes, interpretation is a bad place, ninth is strategy for taking the lesson case, 10 process for establishing new identity, next inevitable quality for every act, the 12th is interpretation is not natural quality. Now point number 13. Activity motivated by environment. Is that it is not an unrelated but a related cause. So many factors play an important role in the formation. In other words, entrepreneurship is related to environment. So when an entrepreneur takes any decisions regarding the production part, he has to keep in mind all the factors of the external environment. It includes social, economical, political, geographical, psychological factors. So whatever this factor suggests, accordingly a new term has to be given to the production. Thus entrepreneurship is not a matter of object, maybe single decisions, but it is the child of the environmental conditions. So an entrepreneur has to decide the proposal of the production of the things, keeping in the mind all the factors described above, make changes in the quantity, in the form of. Thus, it means an entrepreneur does not have to sit passively against the external environmental changes. But he has to give creative answers by introducing the change in the production skillfully according to the changing conditions. So that his production system can stand and exist against the changes in external condition and continuous external. So he should be motivated by the environment. But external changes, the external condition is happening. So for that purpose, he is producing the goods. While he is producing the goods, that goods are not going to harm to the environment. He should try to produce a goods in such a way that the external condition won't affect. According to the situation, according to the changes in the environment, he should handle this properly. If it is doing so, then he is having the entrepreneurship quality in him. If it is not doing properly, so he don't have that . So this thing is also essential. Now the 14th one. Professional tendency. Professional tendency is another characteristic of an entrepreneurship. It means entrepreneurship indicates a person industrious and the professional tendency. This tendency provides him inspiration for the imagination of founding new industry. It's planning and starting the industry. So, new industries and the business are established in the society and the economic development of the country becomes the possible. Thus, the professional tendency is a psychological aspect of a person that plays a very important role in learning towards his profession. So, the professional regarding the is 8 point is establishing, sorry, interpretation is a practice. 9 point strategy for taking the best risk. 10 point is process of establishing the new identity.